Hello scientists, welcome to Dropout Math. So this video, I will have a conversation with you about whether you need a degree to start working as a scientific illustrator. So the short answer is no, you don't need a degree to work as a freelance illustrator, but there are some advantages that you have if you have a degree. So a few of you guys have asked me about the career path of scientific illustrator, and one of the common questions I get is what kind of study that I need to go through to become a scientific illustrator and whether I need a degree to start working on scientific illustration. Because a lot of you guys have studied science. You're also studying PhD or master in a scientific subject and also possibly working in academic research already. So taking a new degree can be quite a big leap in terms of the career change. So I get a lot of these questions whether it is necessary to obtain a degree. And so the answer, like a quick one, is no, you don't need a degree if you want to start working as a scientific illustrator. I have seen people who is operating as a scientific illustrator who have not gone to official scientific illustration degree. And they are, I think they're, a lot of them are physicians, doctors who just have a hobby of drawing, and then they started it as a side hustle in addition to their medical practice. So that is some empirical proof that you can definitely start as a scientific illustrator without a degree. However, I have to say there are some advantages you will have if you have a degree. So for my personal experience, there are I think two biggest advantages. So first is that it is easier for you to be recognized by the big institutes and companies that you are a professional scientific illustrator, have you had a degree. In my case, I get to go give workshop at the University of Oxford and also Einstein Center of Neuroscience in Berlin and all these universities around the world. I think mainly really, it was because I have a degree and professionally trained as a scientific illustrator. So these event organizers at the university is confident enough for me to provide a professional workshop to their PhD and faculty members. I very vividly remember that when I was arranging a workshop with the Dunn School of Pathology at the University of Oxford, which is an institute where they discover penicillin, and the event organizer specifically in the email said that, oh, it is really nice to have a professional scientific illustrator to come and give a workshop to our PhD students. So that was one of the big moment I realized there is a big advantage in having a degree, which is there are these very great opportunities at very prestigious institutes that you will have access to. So that is one pro that you would have for your if you study a scientific illustrator degree. And the second one is that some of the knowledges about the scientific illustration field, I strongly think that you could only learn it through going through a structural program. There are some very established convention within the scientific illustration discipline, and there are some style guidelines that you really have to follow if you are creating very professional scientific illustration. So a few examples that I would say, I would think of right now, is that first is how the convention of organizing visual contents can lead to certain interpretation of your visual storytelling. That had I not gone to a degree, I would never become aware it has such a strong psychological impact on the viewers. for instance, for Western viewers, it is they have a tendency, they have a habit of reading things from left to right. So if you arrange things from right to left, and then there, sometimes it can create an entire different interpretation of your story. So these are the very essential conventions, I think, that you would not have a very structural knowledge established if you have not gone through a scientific illustration program. And another one is that there are certain convention in the usage of color within the medical illustration convention. Certain colors are conventionally used on certain anatomy structures. So those things, I think it's very important if you want to present yourself as a also operate as a professional scientific illustrator and medical illustrator. So like really by going through these programs, you can you will know that how a really like a professional scientific illustrator would work on these cases and collaborate with the scientist. So these are the advantages that you have if you have gone through a degree. But as I mentioned earlier, there are also people who started operating as a scientific illustrator without a degree. So there are some also an advantage of, there are some also some advantages of that. So from what I observed is that because they usually are already like doctors and also scientific researchers. So essentially your colleagues are your potential customers. And so when they started off this scientific illustration side hustle, it is very easy for them to acquire clients if their clients trust their capacity of illustrating for if their colleagues trust in their capacity of illustrating for them. So there are advantages in having a degree and not having a degree. Just evaluate by yourself that how much risk that you would like to take in order in pursuing a career in scientific illustration. If you want to have it as a side hustle on top of your scientific career, then you don't need to go through a degree. You can just take some workshops and online courses to familiarize yourself with some principles. You can also check out DrawBioMed to learn scientific illustration. And I think these will be enough for you to use as a side hustle on top of your scientific regular daytime job. However, if you are really serious about becoming like a professional artist and also really want to embody yourself with the profession of scientific illustration, then going through accredited degree in scientific illustration or medical illustration, I think that will help you a lot if you're going towards that direction. So yeah, let me know in the comments that what else are you curious about the scientific illustrator career, or if you are a scientist who are thinking about career questions that or about career switching, you're all very welcome to comment below to let me know. And if I have experience in that situation, I'm very glad to share my experience with you guys. So yeah, and make sure to subscribe to DrawBioMed, and turn on the notification bell so you get to see these videos of my conversation with you. And I wish you all happy dropout math, and I look forward to seeing you in the future videos.